guys, Noten here, back with another video. So this is a little bit more of a look to the future video with crit item explorations. So you're like me, I saw this on Reddit and I was like, huh, no shit, are they really changing it? Because I recently saw a thing again on Reddit, Riot Freak, the pun man himself, talked about how he was going to, or how he would like to rework, or not rework, but how he would change and kind of balance the crit AD carries. And basically what I was only able to listen to a little bit, I'll be honest, because I was in class. But essentially what he was talking about was, he says that most of the crit AD carries function the same. So then, you know, he lists some examples, Ashe, what was it? It was like Ashe, Trist, Jinx, those kinds of people. They'll kind of do the same thing. They kind of sit there and they'll right click you to death. He's like, no, of course they have something to differentiate you. Like, Jinx gets excited, so she gets more attack speed. Ashe gets her Q, so she gets a little bit more ADAS. Trist gets her attack speed and has the bomb to help increase. But overall, they do just right click you and pretty much kill you. So I do agree with that. So then, only 4 hours ago, this is the... You see, yeah, you can see the time and dates. Yeah, 12:21, 10:57 p.m. 4 hours ago, however you say that, put up crit item explorations. So here to talk a bit about crit items, bouncing some ideas and getting some discussion going. The exact details are still in flux. Don't get caught up on the numbers too big, too small. Feedback is still welcome, but he's curious to hear what we all think. So his goal, so the team's goals. Crit users have an item path they're excited about. They have defensive items or defensive options that aren't way off curve. And crit users are more satisfying in solo queue for all levels of play. So goal one, I want to go over that first. So an item path they are excited about. So to me, whenever I think item path I'm excited about, I think assassins. It's pretty clear cut what's going to happen. If like take for example, Duskblade. Whenever you get the Duskblade, you think Talon and you think Zed. These people, and Kha'Zix and Rengar. These people who go into the shadows, literally or figuratively, and come out, auto-attack you, and one-shot you, right? With Zed, it's when like, you get the thing whenever you go out of sight. So for Zed, it's his ultimate. For Talon, it's his ultimate. As soon as you come out, you get the auto-attack. Generally, as Talon, you'll either W, Q, or whatever, then you get the auto-attack. Same thing with Zed. Rengar just straight jumps at you and kills you with the Q. So that's what I think about excited. Then like Yol moves. It's pretty clear cut what you're going to do with that. Generally your Talon, again, your Rengar. Whenever you get that item, you're excited because, oh, you gain your movement speed now. You can roam. You can do a bunch of shit. It's kind of fun. I can't remember the name. It's the purple one that I always forget. Edge of Night. Whenever you get that, you think, oh, they have easy to hit CC, whether it's like an Ahri charm or a Pike Q, a Thresh Q, is one CC that you need to get out of the way. So you get that. So I'm genuinely excited about that. Ginsu's is another item that I think is something that's great. I love getting that item. That item is really fun. It gives you attack speed, it gives you AD, it gives you AP, a lot of stuff that helps out a lot of the more niche carries, such as Kai'Sa, Varus, Cog. So that's pretty sweet. The current crit path right now, as of the time making this video, is Stormraiser into a Zeal item, which is generally either Static Shift, Rapid Fire, Phantom Dancer. Well, I guess all of them now that I think about it. Yeah. So you go Stormraiser, you go your Zeal item, you go your Infinity Edge. Typically a Zeal item, it could be a situational item depending on how it's going, but generally for your first three, that's what you're getting. That's not fun, and I'll tell you why. Back before they reworked the AD carries, it was, for me at least, BF Sword Boots into a completed Zeal item, Infinity Edge, Zeal item, Survival item, and then whatever you need, so if they're ever like heavy, LDR, or whatever. That was fun because you could really see once you got around three or so items, you were doing damage. Like, you were doing some serious damage. A little too much damage, I agree with, but damage nonetheless. It was a fair amount of, or fair, not as in balance-wise, but it was a sizable amount of damage. it was fun to get because you could visually see what was happening. Right now, Storm Razor, you get that. Yeah, your first attack's crit-based, but that, let's be honest, that was purely a Band-Aid patch. That was purely a Band-Aid patch. That was not meant to be there for the long term, in my opinion. I don't know. I can't say as if I talk to Riot employees, but I mean, if somehow they're talking to this, dude, hit me up. I'm free to chat whenever, pretty much. But it was a Band-Aid patch. It wasn't like it was meant because they were like, shit, we took away a lot of their early damage, so now we're going to give them this just in case. Well, now you don't get to four or five items on your AD carry, so pretty much every crit AD carry is forced to buy Storm Razor purely to have something to get them into the late game, which is not fun to have. I don't feel like I do much damage. I don't. I mean, unless you're like Jinx with her rocket, yeah, you do a sizable amount of damage with it, but for the most part, you really don't. I don't feel as if I do much damage compared to other people with their one item spikes. I know AD carries aren't necessarily supposed to, but I would like a little early damage to kind of get me there. Hell, even two items, I don't feel like I'm that strong. It really takes that third item, not counting boots, to really begin to do damage to AD carries, which is great if we hit that point, but we don't generally. We don't hit that point where we're getting enough items to where we're scaling. We don't get there because we don't survive. So I agree, the item path isn't that exciting, and then that leads into the next one, defensive options that aren't way off curve. The defensive options and items for an AD carry right now is Maw of Malmortius, and if you're Kai'Sa, Zhonya's, and for everyone else, a Scimitar, or QSS, for that matter. So QSS in Season 6, I believe, I could be wrong about that, pretty sure it was Season 6, got changed to where it no longer gets rid of debuffs, so that counts your Fizz Sharks, your Zed Ultimate, stuff like that. Which was fine, I mean, if it was strong at the time, whatever. But that took away a lot of the defensive stats. Mages right now, and Kai'Sa included, if she does go AP or if she just needs the stats, they have a lot better survival than we do. While we do have a support, and for most part of the game, they like if you have like a Thresh or Blitzcrank or something, they're not really gonna shield you. They don't shield you. So your defensive options, if you're going against a Fed Zed. If you want to shut down a Zed, you pretty much just buy Zhonya's in mid, right? Or whatever. If you're against like an Akali, you buy Hex Drinker, whatever. Well, and as an AD carry, if you're a crit AD carry specifically, this is what it's about. It's about crit users. Crit users don't have that. Crit users have to get that third item, that Zeal item, to be able to scale later, to be able to utilize their Infinity Edge all over that way. So if you buy a defensive item such as a QSS or a Hex Drinker, you're kind of setting yourself back a little bit, which in this meta you just can't do. And it's not fun. It's not fun to have a Hex Drinker, and that's my, like, there is no AD resistant item to my knowledge, unless I am spacing it really hard right now, that's good against them. Like, QSS is good, but it's MR. Maw is good, but again, it's MR. And then finally, more satisfying for all levels of play. So all levels of play is where this gets questionable. This bit right there. I don't know how it is for pro players, but they do pretty well. And this, I've seen this with Ryze, I've seen it with Kalista, I've seen it with Azir. This is this last sentence right here. They can do these first two goals, I think, pretty easily. It's this last sentence here. That's all levels of play. That's the hard part. Because something that's not easily abusable down in the bottom tiers, your bronze through, I would say, early gold. I mean, iron through silver, that's been never your crap. Once you hit gold, I consider you a good player. Even though I may be better than you, whatever, we can get into that. That's a whole different discussion. But let's be honest, whatever. The stuff that's not so easily abused down there can be abused in the highest levels of play that none of us, or most of us, 99% of us, won't get to, because we just don't play that much, we aren't that competitive, whatever. But Kalista's crap, Azir was crap, Ryze is crap, because of these high level players, they abuse these very high skill ceilings. Like, it's that's the hard part to do. So I am interested to see how they do this. I have read through this, I've skimmed over it a little bit, so I will be paraphrasing this. So considering potential directions, see below, direction 1 is more known, 2 a bit more adventurous, and at the end there are a few ideas I can go in either pitch. Direction 1. for Infinity Edge. The Infinity Edge Revert. So let's be honest, we all saw it coming. Yeah. Not surprising. So we do gain crit back with this. I think that this is kind of the way to go. The true damage with the Infinity Edge was a good idea. However, it was, in my opinion, poorly executed. So I kind of agree with this one. Direction 2. Make it to where it's 5,000 gold. And it's a zeal item as well. It's energized. Don't know how you would do that. Because there's no shard, but whatever. So 2BS, a zeal, 5K. So that's what, 26. So that's 3,900. So it's 3,900 plus 1,100 gold to get the full Infinity Edge. That's a shit ton of gold. I'm not going to lie to you. 5,000 gold in this current meta? My ass. This right now, if you were to get it right now, that would be Zeolite. This is kind of just throwing ideas out there. This is what's coming to me immediately. This isn't scripted. What I'm thinking is Zeolitem. Grab this Zeolitem because it still does increase the crit by 50. So yeah, you'd still want that. And then the zeal items. So they're talking about 25% zeal items. I didn't understand this because I'm pretty sure that's what they are now. Maybe they're 20. I don't know. I have to pull it up. Actually, let's do that real quick. League of Legends, zeal. This should just pull up the wiki. Yeah. Okay, so it's 15% right now. They're talking about giving an extra 10% crit. That would be interesting because if they did this and then they did this, so if they did both of these, that's 50%. So this would be 50% crit. So you would still get, you wouldn't overdo it. So that'd be interesting. Same thing with this. So flexible can go in either pitch. So. Hex Drinker. So they're talking about taking away the magic resist to it, and instead giving you the stopwatch to build into it, which I would assume is to kind of just sit there and like just in case, you know. I don't rate this too highly. I would have to see it actually in play. I don't know how this would do, especially whenever you're taking the MR away. That kind of cucks the mid laners, your Zeds, your Talons, who are going against people like Syndra, Akali, Katarina. These people kind of require, or not require, but they do need and like that MR and the shield that you get with the Hex Drinker. I don't think that a longsword and a stopwatch are good enough to compensate for the lack of magic resist. Defensive Phantom Dancer. So this is odd, to say the least, but it is the most ambitious. So they're taking this, adding it to Phantom Dancer, they're giving it AD, AS, crit, and MS. And they're basically taking it away, so instead of this being a 1v1 item, this is a survival crit item. So in my opinion, what would make my day is if they kept Phantom Dancer the way it is, make a new crit item, and give it something along this kind of build path, but keep the Phantom Dancer the way it is. That way we still have a one-on-one crit item for your Veins, Kai'Sa if she wants to, I guess. That way, we can still one-on-one if we want to, but if not, we also have this fourth or fifth crit item that has a similar build path to this so that we do have some survival. I think that would be interesting. Next up, Essence Reaver Broadening. I like this change. Instead of ulting, you now have to do 30% of a champion's HP within 2.5 seconds to grant you 50% attack speed, basic attacks refunding 20% of non ultimate cooldowns. So I don't know who this would be good on. I'm trying to think. You're wanting maximum damage, so this would be like a scaling item. So I'm thinking third or fourth item. So then at that point I'm thinking like a more scaling carry, who's probably like, I'm trying to think, this is like a caster item, so like what, are you still going for Lucian with this? Because, I mean, maybe Sivir would run it, maybe Xayah would run it, but I still don't think it's great. I like this idea. I don't know who it would be viable on. Energized Stormraiser. Sure, I guess. I don't know. I don't really have much of an opinion on this. I mean, it's there, I guess. I don't know how much this will do. And then a multi-proc Storm Razor. So gain a charge every 10 seconds, max 3 charges. Your next basic attack deals 30 to 80 damage, grants movement speed. So I actually like this one over this one. This is a little bit more. This is a little bit more unique, and it does allow you to where, like, say you're like you're at 3 charges. So like, let's say you're like Kate, you can kind of poke with this and have those charges. So I think that'd be interesting. A buff glass whisper, I'll never complain about that really, as I'm typically the one that's using it, and it doesn't really get used against me all that often, because at that point you should be building lethality. So I do like this. I do think that last whisper should be buffed a little bit, but if you're gonna do this, please buff tanks a little bit. People love to bitch about tank meta. Tank meta, well, it's not fun. I dislike strong tanks. I like the front line. I like the idea of I can sit in the back, I have a Maokai, I have a Sion, I have someone in front of me to soak some damage, Nautilus even, to soak up damage and to allow me to use these kinds of items. So if you're going to do this, they need to consider buffing tanks so that this buff doesn't make them shit. A new Maul of Malmortius altogether. So upon taking magic damage, I believe that's the same and this is the same, but instead you're getting more of a magic resist kind of item here. So I'm pretty sure. Let's look this up. Mortius. So I do want to compare this. This is 60 AD, 40 MR, 10% CD. So you're gaining 10 AD, same cooldown, and you're actually losing magic resist. So 20 AD, 10% spell vamp, 20 AD, 10% spell vamp, 10% life steal. So that's the same. So this just me this might like to me this screams get this sooner and then build into this eventually, but you're mainly getting it for the Negatron Cloak. So this will be interesting, and then I guess we can see this. Why not just revert Essence Reaver or add crit, since the new one just seems worse on the champions that use it and a bit better on ADCs, but there is better items for them since they need crit, so why not add crit or revert it? So generally, like the emerging build that's created for fighters, adding crit will remove the users. I don't know how they would do this, because I kind of agree with this guy, because it was meant for Xayah, kind of Ashe, Sivir especially, Lucian occasionally. So I kind of agree with that guy. So how's Yasuo getting 100% crit when the item doesn't give any? Item would just get 50% crit, Yasuo doubles. So basically with Yasuo, if that came through, Zeal item and then Infinity Edge, and that'd still give you the doubling, so or quadrupling. Yeah, 150%, whatever. But that would still give him 100% crit, and then the final comment right now. So curious about the philosophy. Crit items were changed so they would be better against tanks, less vulnerable against squishies. With the consideration of reverting, has crit items not panned out? What problems does reverting the Infinity Edge solve? Crit items were also changed because they were too strong in combination with late games. ADs were considered mandatory because of the sheer power, which I think is a good thing. The sentence right here, I think, is a good thing. Crit items were made more expensive, but came online later. IE changes and changes in direction too would make late game carries much stronger. So this is a few item or a few issues they see with being effective against tanks and less effective against squishies. So hitting tanks as your optimal DPS pattern isn't as exciting as finding. I agree. This sentence right here, as much as I love blowing up tanks, one-shotting a squishy is really fun. That is something I miss about the old system. Tank passive ended up being much better in pro compared to regular, with the result being that crit marks were more useful in pro to normal play. I mean, no shit. This whole sentence, no shit. Again, pros can abuse something that we don't even think about, so this isn't surprising. Satisfaction with split damage numbers is lower. It's kind of interesting how they have it down to a science that if we don't see it, we can even compare it, like, let's say a crit does 500 damage or 250 crit and 250 true damage. I think it's interesting that we'd rather see it as a 500 crit instead of a 250-250 split. So that is interesting that they have this data here. So that does kind of conclude this all. I'm going to scroll back to the top here. So overall, I do think this is a good change. I hope that they take it. I hope that they go slow with this. I do not, as an AD carry main and player myself who got to gold 3 and hopefully we get the diamond this season using them, I do not want to see marksmen just crazy overpowered. I do think that they were OP at the beginning of season 8, and I do think the change was necessary. I think that it was just too much. I do not want to see marksmen become crazy. Because if so, that means I get banned out. That means people bitch. That means I see more posts about how broke AD carries are. I don't want that. I don't want constant AD carry nerfs. I want a consistent meta, whether it's crit AD carries, whatever. I just want AD carries to be good. I don't want them to be broken. I just want them to be good. I don't want to see any more Karthus and Heimerdinger bot, or if they do, even if it's a pro play, whatever. I don't care for seeing that. I do like my AD carries in the bot lane. So, ladies and gentlemen, that does conclude this video. It is a little bit of a longer one. I can't see the recording right now as it isn't over. But, yeah, I do apologize for that. I can go in here this tab. So, if you did enjoy this, twitch.tv/NotenLeague, linked in the description. I do stuff like this pretty much once a week. Generally, if something like this does catch wind. I do discussions occasionally. I definitely do patch overviews with 8.24b. I did a video on that. I am looking forward to 9.1. We are looking at more AD carry changes to more broader. Even Kalista is getting changed, even though they're reducing her E a little bit. They're going to be changing some other things around, so that will be on PvE. So if that does gain traction, I will do another video on that. Thank you all so much for watching this video. I'll see you.